Have you ever heard of someone dying and felt a twinge of envy? I have. That person doesn't have to fight anymore. They don't have to be scared anymore. They can just rest. I've had those sort of thoughts a lot in the last month or so. Adulting is hard. Sometimes it feels like life is just an endless slog of trying to make money to pay more bills. What's the point? Some days I can't see it. And I think about drinking something that's under the sink, or jumping in front of the train just before it comes. Some days I'm riding around Manhattan on my bike, I don't wear a helmet, and I know I'm gonna make a turn and I cannot see what's there. I know I don't know what's there, and I don't care. Some days it's like that. You may have seen me in one of these moments when I was feeling really low and I might have smiled and said, hey, what's up? And you didn't even know that inside I was like, what's it all for? Some days life feels like a heavy boulder that you're just pushing up the mountain and you never get there. You're always just pushing and pushing. I haven't taken this depression lying down. I've done some men's groups, I've done some therapy. And one thing I've learned is that in almost everybody, at the bottom of your emotional well, you're either scared, angry, or sad. What is this world we've constructed where everybody is upset deep down? Being an adult is hard. Life is hard. And we might see people from the outside and think, oh, well, he's got it together, she's got it all together. We don't know what it took to get them to looking like they got it all together today. And if we could look inside them, we'd see they're a mess just like we are. But if you want to feel better, there's a couple of things you can try to do. One thing is gratitude. Just being conscious, writing down the things that you're grateful for. Small things, big things, specific things, real things that you feel grateful for. Try not to forget that feelings change. And when you're trapped in the grip of depression, you may be like, I'll never feel good again. But if you can just remember your feelings will change, then that alone can help you feel better. When things are really tough, it can help to see things on a day-to-day basis, even an hour-to-hour basis. Some days that are really hard, I just make it to 7 o'clock and I'm like, okay, I'm at home for the night with my family. Nothing else can hurt me today. But more than that, it can help to value the tough times, to see them as not a burden, but a blessing. But really, if you can find a reason outside of yourself that you have to keep going on, that will pull you forward. For me, there's two little kids who I've been raising since the day they were born, and I can't leave them now. I can't walk away from them. I can't not know how the story turns out, and I can't have them say, well, my life was changed when my dad was there one day and then he wasn't. No, I have to be there for them. I have to help them. I can't let my problems become their problem. When I was growing up, adults used to say stuff like, I brought you in this world and I can take you out. And I always thought that was ridiculous because that's against the law. If I brought you in this world, then don't I owe you something? Don't I owe you everything that I can give you? How could I let my troubles, my depression, my scars get ahead of taking care of those two little kids? And how could I look at my wife and say, okay, I'm gonna take a dump truck of my problems and dump it onto your plate, and the next 10 years or so of mornings, pickups, parties, homeworks, meltdowns, bedtimes, all that is you, because I gotta go. How could I do that? How could I check out and leave her with all of that? No matter how much pain I'm in, I could never leave my family to make them have to deal with this too. So I'm fighting through this day by day.